Good day to you guys. This is Smile again from Josie Toyek, and in this particular video, I'll be taking you through how to transform your CSV data or how to view your CSV data in Google Earth. There are situations that you actually bring in this data into your QGIS interface, then you might want to actually check the data using Google Earth to confirm if they actually fall in the right location. So in this session, I'll be taking you through how to view your data from CSV in what Google Earth. So please stay tuned. So guys, here we are on the QGIS interface. So let me bring in the coordinates that we have in the CSV formats to the QGIS environment. So I'll go to add delimited test layer. So I can go to the folder where I have the file. This is it, level scores, open. So you can see the preview here, X and Y, longitude and latitude. So you can see the coordinate system WGS84. So click on add. Okay, so this is my data. So now, for you to be able to view your data, your vector data in Google Earth, you might want to know where this or to confirm whether what you collect on the field actually aligns with what's on ground, or the area you collected the coordinates on ground. So you need to save this layer into KML, Key Markup Language. So that's the format that Google Earth is able to will be able to read in your data. So you have to export your data into that format for you to be able to view it in Google Earth. So for you to save your data in Google Earth, what you need to do is you still right click on the layer, then go to export, you save features as. Then here, by default, you should have this S3 shapefile. But because I've been using it over time, that's why I have Key Markup Language. So you should come here. That's the first thing you need to do in this window. You come here and change the format to Key Markup Language. So you scroll to Key Markup Language and select it. So under defining, then you save the file in the folder, your working folder that you have been using. So I'll save it as Lagos Schools. So you can see save as type Key Old Markup Language. So I click on save. So you can see the coordinate reference system, the WGS84. And then symbology, I think you can use the symbol layer here. You can make your file open in the same symbology. Well, just leave it as no symbology because you can still edit it in your collect and hold. You need to do that at all. I just click on OK. So let's add our layers. So you see layers are exported successfully in KML. Look at the file paths in your folder. So click on OK. So now you just need to go to your folder. So let's confirm from our folder. Okay, this is it. So this is a Lagos Schools. So you can actually open your file now by right clicking. Then you click on open, or you can even double click. That is another method. Then the third one is you can even go to Google Earth. I have it open here already. Then you come to the file menu, then use the open option. You see, it took me to the folder that I have my data directly. At times it might take you to a random folder in your system, so you need to navigate to the folder you have your data that you want to open. You see, I double click that folder and my data actually opened. And it took me to the locations where I have my schools. So this is here, it is under temporary places. So while closing your Google Earth, you might save this place. So anytime you open your Google Earth again, then you can find your data. So you can see. So this is the boundary of Lagos State. Yeah, this is the boundary of Lagos State. So this is the schools that have been there. So to confirm, you can just select one. You see, this is Starland Private School. The coordinate system, the description, and the object ID. They are somewhere close to the Kedja airport, the airport here. Another one is Cambridge College Secondary and A Level College. So, as you have a data, open the Google Ads. So, this government collects ruler. So, you have the data opened already. So, you can see that the view is somehow slant. For you to make your image, a satellite image, a bit vertical, you can use the arm button on your keyboard. So let me please so you can see. So this is better. So that's your data. So that's it, guys. See you later.
So guys, that's basically how you bring in your data to Google Ads from the CSV vector on data. So you can see how informative or how useful it is to actually view your data in Google Ads, because there are that way you can actually check if your data fall in the what right location. So don't forget to make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel for more educative video, and if you have questions, please use the comment section. See you guys later. Thank you.